Vaughn for Sam's Sports Report. This woman has identified as bipolar disorder, and in the video that we show next, identifies as lesbian. As a hospitalization and inpatient, she learned about NAMI, the two own of their own, in their own voice, speakers. The African-American ladies had identified as lesbian, just like her. They both had bipolar, just like her. They were both teachers, just like her. She said, "I would never forget it." This story resonated with her story. She said she wanted to be part of an organization, and she was very eager to be part of NAMI. She said whatever NAMI was doing, she wanted to be a part of it. It made her feel whole. As an LGBTQ member, she says, it is the community that's sharing your story. Unafraid was a great part about it. Being able to share your story because someone is the same thing you are. Whether it's a NAMI Connections group, which is where you go around and talk about your week, whether it's a peer-to-peer, which is you train to teach the class, and whether it's a family-to-family, which is where you have families that have a child or adult son or adult daughter have a mental illness, and they teach them how to deal with it. She says, "You would be amazed how interviewed the community is. There are allies that support me," meaning they're straight, but they maybe support gays or they support bis. That's what they would support. "This person stands while with the parents, for example, when you tell them you're a lesbian, gay, or bi. The more you know about NAMI, the more you know you're not alone. It reaffirms you that you can share. It starts with opening up your mouth. It helps, for example, if you have bipolar. It helps you share your story, and it is important. Telling your story, who wouldn't love me?" The person says, "NAMI means to her to live a good life. NAMI means to me living for hope. You are not alone. NAMI means people can share and they don't judge. They don't care if you have a mental illness. Believe me, that's not in all people. Some people don't like people because they have a mental illness. It's just that simple. NAMI doesn't judge. The group guidelines are the same for every NAMI group, and something that I live by. For example, my friend's favorite, Patty, is never give up hope. That's her favorite guideline. They're kind of like the Bill of Rights for a police officer. I like to share my week and what good or bad or tough thing that happened. They don't judge. There's another person that has the same disability that you're sharing within that group. They may have some of the same struggles. It's just a good place. It won't be judged. I share my story. I have another person in common with the same story as I do normally. Even mental health groups, I don't believe, are as good as this. If I didn't do NAMI, I wouldn't have the life I do today. I wouldn't have the hope that I do today. I may not be alive."
Hi, my name is Alika Adair. I have bipolar disorder. I'm from Baltimore, Maryland, and I identify as a lesbian. I stumbled upon NAMI, ironically, during a hospitalization. So I went from inpatient to outpatient, and during one of the outpatient visits, we had two interim voice speakers, and I'll never forget them because they were African-American, they both were teachers like I was, they both had bipolar disorder, and their stories really resonated with my story. I approached the woman and said, "Okay, I want to be a part of this organization, like, tell me what I need to do." I knew whatever NAMI was offering, I wanted to be able to be in that same space, to be able to feel whole again, to feel like I had a future, to feel like I had something to live for. As an LGBTQ NAMI member, what I found to be most important and much needed is community and
sharing your story and being unafraid and being bold and vulnerable in sharing your struggles, whatever your struggles are, because someone is dealing with the same exact thing or situation that you are. So if you just start off with a small piece of, you know, yourself, starting off small or slow, whether it's at a NAMI connection support group or a family support group or in a peer-to-peer class, you'd be amazed how you look up and you've inadvertently built a community. There's your new ally, but there's your new best friend. Or there's that person that's gonna stand by you while you go and tell your parents that you're gay or lesbian or trans. Like, that's what you need. We need community. People coming together and not being afraid to talk to each other. Because once you're able to tell your story, you just ultimately begin to feel better about yourself. And you also have people that affirm what you're going through because you realize that you're not alone. The more I was open, I felt like a light. Like when you're quiet and you're closed off, it's like you feel dark. It just reaffirms what you're already feeling about yourself, like that you're not worthy. And that's so not true. But it starts with opening your mouth and just speaking your truth and knowing that you're not alone. It's like, say it out loud. Like, I say out loud, I have bipolar disorder. I say out loud that I'm a lesbian and I'm married to a woman. And being able to do that, like, that gives me strength in and of itself, and no one can say anything else to me because I've already put the biggest parts about me out on the table. So then you just have the rest of this glorious me. Who wouldn't want that? NAMI means living a good life. And NAMI is hope.
This is Sam Vaughn, Sports Park. Now on to sports. The Royals lose 6-2 yesterday. Guardians took the lead on a home run, but after that, it was understandable that the umpire called it fair. It landed into the netting and then went into fair territory. So you could see how he called it fair. What was not understanding is how he called it fair after he viewed it. It was about a foot foul, and that changed the game forever. The umpire crew chief reeled it fair. That changed the ball game and may have been one of the Guardians' pivotal changing points. I'm not saying it's what they won because they won 6-2. But it didn't hurt. And they could have won because of that. One of the American League Pitcher of the Year, Seth Lugo, will go for the Royals and for the Indians. It'll be Logan Allen. For the Cubs and Brewers, 39-45. Brewers at 49-34. Kyle Hendricks will be on the mound for the Cubs, and Freddie Peralta will be on the mound for the Brewers. First pitch, 1:10 as well. The Reds will play the Cardinals at 1:15. Hunter Green will go for the Reds, and Lance Lynn will both having solid seasons. And that's it for baseball. And that's CM on Sports.
We are following breaking news out of Milwaukee. 11 people have been injured following the Cubs-Brewers game due to an escalator malfunction at the ballpark. According to the Brewers, 5 people were treated for injuries at American Family Field. 6 others were transported to area hospitals. None of the injuries is life-threatening. The team released a statement on X explaining in part an escalator at American Family Field moving fans from the terrace to lodge level malfunctioned, resulting in an increased downward speed. It goes on to say the on-site physician and EMS were on scene immediately. We'll bring you the latest on this as we get it.
But if they don't, I don't think we're 10 minutes away from the San Antonio Chiefs. I don't. But I don't want to find out how far away we are either. Okay? I don't want to walk right up to the edge of it and watch the Mayflower moving vans pulling up like they did in Baltimore to take away the Colts. I don't want to screw around with that. And I think was a very compelling finishing argument that Sean Tarwater made. Like, do you really want to leave this to chance? And for me, I don't care. Put it Kansas, put it Missouri. I don't care. Just keep it in the metro area. I don't care.